Hey guys, it's me Drew. So I'm back with another video. I know it's been about a month since my last video, but every time I try and film something literally happens. Like, I was trying to film my unicorn brushes.
Fan brush.
My dogs are trying to escape in the room. I tried to film my purchase review. Doing that, oh, for fuck's sake! And then I tried to film like kind of boy stories and talking about, dating tips for guys to date trans women. Anyway, going into the sex story. So, me being me, first date blowjob person, he unbuttons his jeans and then it's just there. Like, there. I'm him, you're me, it's just like there. I was looking at it and I was like, oh! And the O isn't because it was big, the O was because I've never seen anything like it before. You know, like the end of a balloon where, like, when you tie a balloon up and it's got that little, like, thing on the end? That was basically what, like, his foreskin was like on his willy. It was so weird. And my camera died. So I literally rushed through it and it was a complete disaster, but I am gonna get them videos out to you. Probably not the unicorn brushes, because I feel like so many people have seen them now. And yeah, I feel like I don't really need to do that review anymore because there's so much information online. My experience with them, however, I absolutely love them. In fact, you know what? I might as well just put the bit that I filmed in here now. So one thing that I want to say is the detail in, this company, Unicorn Lashes, is by far amazing. I've never seen anything like it. Now, I am one for like packaging. I think that packaging can really make a product sell well. And also it just makes it that much more special. So when I got this in the post, I was instantly blown away by it. The fact that there is so much detail, not only with the box, but what's inside the box is amazing. So when you purchase these, they come in a box like this, and it says you've got unicorn male on the front. And it's pretty light, it's not too heavy. So yeah, you will open them. Oh, look at that. That is such, like, I've never seen anything like it. Like, the detail and artwork in this is just incredible. She's just beautiful. So yeah, when you open them, it comes like this, and I literally just thought I broke my fucking statue then, and I would have been absolutely pissed off if that had broke. So we're gonna start again. The fact that, when you buy this and it comes like this, you actually feel like it's really magical. And I was just like sat there, like just staring at it like this. So yeah, I was amazed by it. Now it comes with a little another picture, the same picture that's on the cover. And what's on the back of this is it gives you a list of the brushes, and it also gives you tips. So it says, "Hi beautiful unicorns, here's a quick one-on-one guide to getting the most out of your new brushes. 1 to 10 left to right in the diamond bag." So each brush, it lists what brush is inside and it tells you how you can use them. And yeah, I really, really liked this. I just think that, not enough brands do this with their brushes. They just expect you to know how to use them. So I think this is a really good guide, because there were a few brushes in this that I was like, I know what I would use that for, but if someone wasn't really into makeup, they might not know what it's for. So this is a really good breakdown of how to use it. So I was really impressed by that. Now, the first thing as well is you not only obviously get the brushes, but you also get this little sample of their brush cleaner. So this is the Swirl and Sparkle brush cleaner. Now, I have used this. I'm going to open it just to show you that I've used it. And I'm going to give my review on it. So yeah, you get loads in this and it's really surprising. So what you do is you dampen your brush and you dampen this product and you swirl it in and you basically clean your brushes and then you remove the dirty residue. So yeah, I was really impressed with the fact that they put this in there because, you know, for me, when I'm cleaning my brushes, I use like Surgical Spirit. So I was really intrigued to use this. Now I'm going to give my review on what I thought of this. So in the bottom of the bag, it comes with like these little like paper tearaways, but there are loads of little diamonds and jewels in the bottom as well, which I thought was like quite pretty. If I can get one out for you. Yeah. Oh, you can't see my nails in this light, but they're like rainbow glitter, which is a shame. But I'm obsessed with holographic at the moment. So yeah, the diamond bag is this. Amazing. Again, just a little detail. It's different and it's large, so you can fit all your brushes in. I'm really glad that it comes with this because I've got bags for my makeup, but I never have anything to put my brushes in. So I end up having to put them in like paper bags and stuff. So I'm really glad that I can finally put not only my unicorn brushes in this, but also my normal brushes. And I have put them in here, but obviously I've removed them for this review. So it comes with like a little unicorn zip handle, and you have the brushes. So here are all 10. Now, I have used all these brushes and I've cleaned them. So you get like a smoothing brush, which is this one. You get an angled brush, a powder brush, a contour brush, which is like one where it's quite square. You get a concealer brush, you get a blending brush, you get a fan brush. My dogs are trying to escape in the room. But yeah, I do love the brushes and I use them now and again, but I must admit, like, you know, I'm still a favourite of the like Elemaska brushes, and I love, you know, MAC brushes too. Even though they're not cruelty free, I still like using them. I literally have been working all over Christmas. I didn't have any time off apart from Christmas Day, and today is New Year's Eve, which is my first day off. So every time I've had like the odd day here and there, I've been that tired and exhausted that it's just been one of them moments where literally I just don't really want to do anything, and like seriously, I just want to sleep. Obviously, Christmas, like everyone knows, I'm really into comics, I'm really into action figures, you know, I collect them. One that I really, really wanted, I actually dressed up as her for Halloween. I did a couple of looks, which I'll put now. So I did the Joker, which was the Jared Leto Joker version. I had all the fake tattoos and I had like a grill and stuff. It was pretty awesome, and everyone thought that the green hair was my real hair, and I was like, no, it's the wig. And then I did Catwoman, which I had painted the mask on my face and wore like this sexy little PVC dress. And then I dressed up as Ladypool, and I actually made the mask on my face with tissue, and then I did all like the skin, like where it's all like burn and like there's lots of skin tissue and scarring and stuff like that. Like, I did all that with tissue as well. But the actual mask, like, I didn't have any red paint to paint it, so I was like, what the hell can I do to do the mask? And I've not even practiced this, by the way. I just winged it, and I had to go to work straight after. So I'm pretty happy that it turned out. But for the mask, I used like red lipstick, and I like painted my whole face with red lipstick. It was quite bizarre. And then I set it with like red eyeshadow, and it lasted all day. And it almost like the red lipstick like gave kind of like a sheen to it, so it almost looked like it was leather. But anyway, yeah, I wanted Lady Deadpool. So this is like a statue figure. It's got no articulation to it, which that doesn't really bother me. I know some people do. But yeah, like she's just awesome. She's got, I mean, what's not to love? She's got massive boobs, which I'm very jealous of. She's got long blonde hair. And yeah, she's pretty tall. Like, she nearly chopped me then. I didn't realise how big this figure was gonna be. I thought it was only gonna be a little kind of like 6-inch figure, but no, I absolutely love her. Like, she's amazing. And then I've got the Jared Leto Joker statue, which I'll show you from a video that I previously filmed before. So you can see, like, I'm not even joking, I have been trying to film videos, but, like, I've had, like, either a disturbance or my camera's just, like, pulled the cord and I lost it. In fact, no, one of the reasons why I couldn't make videos was because the charger, so basically my camera has a little plug that plugs into it and that charges it up. So I always have it on charge while I'm filming. Anyway, I had not been able to make videos for a while because I lost my charger and I finally found it and I didn't have a case to put it in. So I put it in my glasses case and then I actually had a driving lesson, took my glasses with me and then I left the glasses in the driving instructor's car. Now, I didn't really want to go back with him because I didn't really think that the lessons were that great. And they seemed pretty pricey as well. Like, I don't think, you know, for what I was paying, I got a decent lesson. Anyway, I left my glasses case in the car and I was too scared. Yes, like, even me, I was too scared to actually call them up and be like, look, like, can you bring my glasses case back? I don't want any lessons either, but can you bring it back? So I was like, screw it, I'll just go out and buy another one. And it took me forever to try and find, like, a little charging plug because I was constantly working. I just didn't get any time off. So, yeah, I finally have it. So that's one of the reasons why I couldn't film, but now I'm back. Also, because I don't pretty much, like, stay here anymore. Like, I'm usually at Gavin's. So I don't really get a chance to film in a nice setup like this. But if you guys aren't really bothered and you just want me to film, even if the lighting's not very good and whatnot, then I'm happy to do that. But I feel like because I've got, like, my channel kind of looking okay, like, I wanted to keep up with it. So, yeah, and plus I love my comic background. Like, what's not to like about that? But yeah, so for Christmas I got loads of action figures. I got, like, a harness, which is like a bra. I'll put a picture up and what it looks like. There you go. I'm going to be doing a photo shoot as well. Like, if people follow me on Twitter, I used to do a thing called TNA Tuesdays where I basically posed in my underwear. I'll be doing them again, like, pretty much soon. So yeah, I kind of stopped for particular reasons and now it's like, you know what, like, I want to do it, so I'm gonna do it. My mum got me, like, this Harley Quinn throw and a Harley Quinn t-shirt, and I also got a Harley Quinn picture, which, let me just go get it for you. This is the picture. It's pretty big, that's what she said. But yeah, I love it. Like, the image, oh, you can see my ring light in it. Oh, I'm gonna say you can see my ring, but you can't see my ring. But yeah, I love it. It's amazing. So I'm going to figure out where to put this because I'm not sure where to put it. But we'll find somewhere. But yeah, I got my mum, like, some Vivienne Westwood earrings because I know that she likes Vivienne Westwood. And I got my dad a Vivienne Westwood tie. People probably think I'm loaded by buying Vivienne Westwood, but I'm not. I either get it, you know, a discount or whatnot. So yeah, I actually bought, like, I remember someone says, like, you wear Vivienne Westwood to work. Now I've got the bondage boots that I treated myself with when I used to get, like, a different commission scheme, and I treated myself to them and I wear them constantly. But the dresses that I buy, like, I just go on eBay and I type in Vivienne Westwood dress or Vivienne Westwood top and stuff, and you can get, like, secondhand stuff for next to nothing. Like, I don't care if someone's been wearing it. As long as it's washed, you know. One girl's trash is another girl's treasure. So yeah. So in terms of filming, I did a video about things, you know, like dating tips for transgender people. And I want to post it, but then I don't because, like, some of the things that I was talking about in it was a little bit personal and rude, and I don't know if you guys want me to talk like that, but yeah, I was talking about past experiences. Also, if you can hear a hairdryer, like, my mum's drying her hair next door, like, seriously. But yeah, so that's pretty much it and what's been going on over Christmas. So I'm probably just gonna put all my videos that I've done in this one and just make it a big mishmash. So don't really know what this is gonna turn out like, but hope you all liked it. Thanks for subscribing. Please keep subscribing and being supportive. Mwah. Beep.